Hey there, and welcome to the locker room. Coach Giggs here, and today's message, attitude toward work. Attitude toward work. I want to first encourage all of you to read the story about an African farmer, and the title of the story is Acres of Diamonds. It's a story about a man who sold his land in search of diamonds that had been told were all over the African continent. He ended up selling his property, looking for diamonds, spent his entire life searching for them, ended up broke, despondent, penniless, bent over a riverbed on his old property that he had sold. As this true story goes, this man, this farmer, sold his land so he could go find these precious stones that were discovered ultimately and considered the biggest diamond deposit in history. The man sold what he had, his property, to find what was already under his feet the whole time. You see, that property he sold was the property that to date was the largest diamond deposit in the history of the world. Sold it to someone else in search of diamonds elsewhere. The person he sold it to obviously became very wealthy. You see, each of us is standing in the middle of his or her own acres of diamonds. If we will only have the wisdom and patience to intelligently and effectively explore the work in which we are now engaged, we will usually find that it contains all the riches we seek, whether financial, intangible, or both. So before we go running off to what we think are greener pastures, let's make sure that our own is not just as green, or perhaps even greener. Each morning, ask yourself these questions. How can I increase my service today? There are rare and very marketable diamonds lurking all about me. Have I been looking for them? Examining every facet of my work and industry? Are there better ways to do what I'm presently doing? What are they? How will my work be performed 20 years from now? Can I do it now? You see, everything in the world is in a state of evolution and improvement. So how can I do now what will eventually be done anyway one day? Ask yourself these important questions and bring more passion, more conviction, and ideas to your career and to your work that you do every single day. And when you do this and you seek to learn more, to become better at what you're doing, one day at a time, you will wake up one of the competent ones of your generation, as the great philosopher said, and you'll be living your best life. Thanks for joining me. We'll see you tomorrow in the locker room. Bye-bye.
If you've enjoyed and feel the Daily Locker Room has served as an inspiration in your life, why not share it with a friend by sending them the daily message?